It's time for College Hoops 2K8. The away team square up against the Vermont Catamounts. This is going to be a terrific matchup. Hi there, everyone. We're here at Patrick Gym. I'm Vern Lundquist, here with Bill Raftery and Tracy Wolfson. What's your take on this, Bill?
I'll really be watching the matchup at the four spot. Number 34 is a top-notch power forward. He's a gunner from long range, and that really opens up things for his teammates. Brooks is also a star at the power forward position. You can't help but notice what a smart player he is. He understands all the little aspects of the game. Both of them are great competitors. It should be a compelling game to watch.
Pushes it to the left wing. Hammond scores the opening field goal. They're up by three. Hen passes it back to the wing. It was drained by number 10. And it's now all knotted up. Takes a three. Buried by number 15. He's got three. Dangerous pass. Number 14 unloads. Connects inside the key. But they're still behind by one. Let's check in with our sideline reporter, Tracy Wilson, who has some info for us.
Thanks, guys. Earlier on, I caught up with the Catamounts coach. He said it's no secret that we have guys who can knock down the three, and we're not going to shy away from letting them do their thing. These shooters can be deadly when they get going, and he wants them to show just how dangerous they can be.
Thank you, Tracy.
Pulling down the rebound. Off the deck.
Hammond catches it. Right wing. Launches one from beyond the arc. Perfect shot by number 14. They're in front, 8-6. Number 15. Throws it up, hits the tray. He's shooting 100% from downtown. Just over 8 minutes left in the half. Swing pass, right wing. Number 10 has it, right wing. And gets it to go. And now up by two. The shot. Nice job on the assist by number 15. It's a tie ball game. Number 10 brings it up the floor. Number 14 from downtown gets it to four. They're now up by three. Dishes to the left. Brooks backs him down for three. Grab by number 32. Just over 7 minutes left in the half.
Oh, the big fella with a tough rebound. No denying him on that one.
Rivers inbounds the ball.
There's no question what kind of defense they're in there. In a minute.
The shot bounced up and in. Soft touch by Brooks. And they're now down by three. Number 14 pulls the trigger. Answers right back with his own three. He's 3-for-3 from 3-point range. Number 15. Number 32 snatches it down.
If they leave a shooter like him open next time, believe me, he's gonna make them pay for it.
Let's it go. The trifecta on number 14. That's 15 unanswered points. Number 15 takes the shot, uses the pump fake, and then cans the three-pointer. He's got nine. The Catamounts have been lights out from beyond the arc. Feeds it to the left side. Number 32 finishes in close by 8. Laid in with the D draped all over it. But they still trailed by 6. Number 14 inbounds the ball. Under 6 minutes left in the half. Number 32 gets it. Top of the key. Number 10 passes it to the wing. Stolen by the away team. Takes it in. Great finish by number 4. They close the gap to 4. 10 brings it up the floor. Left wing. Raises up. No good on the open jaw. They've still got a 4-point lead. Withers tosses it up. Misses with the D in his face.
Fantastic job. Pressure the defense on that shot. He got right in his face and threw that one off.
Laid in by number 34. They're in front, 27-21. Number 15. Dishes it to the right. Number 14 inbounds the ball. Under 5 minutes left in the half. Number 10 uses the crossover. Easy look. The shot was short by number 14. But they're still out in front by 4. Passes right wing. Backs in. Crook puts it up. He's off from 14 feet out. From deep. Sunk. By number 10. He's shooting 100% from deep. Crook nails the jump shot. And they're now behind by 5. Has it. Left wing. And no luck on the 3-point attempt. They're still up by 5. Brooks shoots it. Hits it from 3-point land. He's 2-for-2 from beyond the arc. About 3.5 minutes left in the half. Left wing. Pulls the trigger. The jumper was parried by Penn. They're now out in front by 4. Number 15 inbounds the ball. Number 15 behind the arc. Connects. He's got 12.
This looks like a 1-3-1 matchup here. This is a great defense to trap with.
Takes it up. Grabbed inside by number 15. Hammond hands it off. Brooks releases. Takes the lead. They take a 2-point lead. 2:44 left in the first half. Number 32 shoots. Answers right back with his own three. They lead by 1. Withers gets it. Baseline. The last shot laid gently in. Number 10 brings it up.
What a seesaw battle. These teams just keep going right after each other.
Let's it go. 17-footer missed by number 14. That's the shot you work for, Bill, even though he's not their number one option.
The defense will have to show him some respect because he will hit that given another chance.
10. Number 32 dishes to the free throw line. Number 34 goes up, banks it off the glass and in. But they're still behind by 1. Puts up the trail. All net in the shot by Withers. They're up 41-37. 1:29 left in the first half. passes to the left. Number 10 connects on the baseline jumper. They narrow the gap to two. These people are looking. I think it's getting louder here. Losses it over. Pizza to the right wing. Hammond fires. Nice speed by number 4. And they're now out in front by 4. 55 seconds left in the first half. Number 14. For three. Sinks it. He's shooting 100% from long range. With the shot, they answered right back with a three-pointer by Withers. He's 2 for 2 from downtown. Number 10 bounces it to the right wing. Number 4, way up court. Down low. The layup good by Hammond. He's got 11. We'll head into the break with the score 48-42. What do you think of the first half, Bill?
Well, I don't want to rule out the possibility of a comeback, Vern. It hasn't been pretty so far, but there is plenty of time.
And now it's time to show you our player of the half, Bill.
Brooks has been just deadly, Vern. The hoop must look 5 feet wide to him right now because it doesn't seem like he's missing anything, inside or out. He's been an offensive force, absolutely on fire.
Tremendous effort from our player of the half. Number 14 inbounds it to start the second half. Skips it to the right side. Number 10 behind the arc. Count it. He's 4 for 4 for the game. Withers. Missed. But they're still up by 3. Kicks it out to the perimeter. And all tied up. Withers from about 19 feet. Nothing but net. He's shooting 57% for the game. Throws it up.
He grabs the rebound. Well, they got the shot they wanted, but sometimes they just don't go in.
Withers dumps it off. Number 4. Has it on the strike. It's in for 3. They push their lead to 5. Number 14 inbounds the ball. Number 14 throws it up. Hits the 3-pointer. 20 points and he leads all in scoring. The visitors have been dialed in from long range. Number 15 takes the 3. Missed. Still a 2-point lead. Passes it to the wing. In. Number 10 shoots it. Gets the go-ahead bucket. They got on this roll a while ago and just haven't looked back. Just over 8 minutes left in the second half.
They've got their defense and it's minute.
Here's the spin move. It's blocked.
With the rejection. I love the D. Get it out of here.
Number 10 from long range. Buries it. And they're up by 4. The away team has been on the wrong side of this long run.
And Tracy's got a report for us.
The head coach is not at all happy with the drought they're going through and told his assistants to find a way, any way, to turn this one around.
Thanks, Tracy.
From downtown,
it was nailed by number 32.
They lead 60-56. Number 50 gets it. Left wing.
What a great setup on that delivery. What a play.
Pass. Left wing. Number 14. Beyond the arc. The box. And they're now up by five. The visitors are really strong. Withers. Catches it. Right wing. Puts it up. Nice pump fake to set up the three by number 15.
20 points, and he's his team's leading scorer. Number 34 unloads. Nails the simple jumper. He's got six. Under 7 minutes left in the second half.
Number four bounces it to the high post. Open look. Swish through by Brooks.
They're now down by two.
Number 34 takes it up.
Fasten your seatbelt. Here's the State Farm drive of the game. That's a go-to dive right there, partner.
Withers inbounds the ball. Number four brings it up court. Right wing from downtown. Made by number 15. But they're still down by one. Feeds it to the wing. Number 14 raises up. Can't connect from the wing. But they're still out in front by one. Withers. Flip up and in on that last layup.
He gets up close and personal and closes the deal.
Leaves no room for error and no room for anybody to do anything about it. Tries the spin move.
The visitors have been red hot from downtown. Skips it down low. No good in the last layup by Withers. Number 34.
Did a good job to grab that rebound. Perfect position that time.
That one was drilled by number 34. He's 5-for-6 for the game. Tosses it up. The jumper from the elbow made by Withers. They cut it to one. Number 32. All alone. Gets the thunder bounce off the side of the rim. He's shooting 80% for the game. Withers gets it in the paint. Stolen away by Vermont.
Who's more worried about scoring with the ball knocked? That's why you squeeze it in.
Number 14 takes it up. About 4.5 minutes left in the second half. Hammond from deep. He snatches it off the glass. The last layup was dropped in by Withers. Number 14 inbounds the ball.
Wow, it's been an offensive showcase for both these teams. What fireworks.
Number 32. He rips down the rebound.
Hammond went after that rebound hard. Great work.
Hammond goes up. It's blocked. Number 4. Jacks up a three. Sinks it. He's shooting 66% from three-point range.
The crossover.
Number 10.
Unloads. He grabs the rebound.
The visitors still hold a narrow lead.
The D recognized the shot was coming and got out there on him. Nicely done.
They increase their lead to four. Number 10 dishes it to the left wing. Number 14
to put an end to the run. Nothing but net.
He's got 27. Withers inbounds the ball. Number 4 is one basket away from a double-double. get back to the action. In. Takes the shot. Knocks down the trifecta. He's fourth to five from beyond the arc. 2:47 left in the game. The visitors will take a timeout. They're up by one. 2:45 left in the game. Beats it to the corner. Number 50 gets the long range shot to fall. They're ahead 82-78. It goes out of bounds.
These players don't look like they enjoy playing together at the moment, Fern. And that pass illustrates what I'm talking about.
Number 4 brings it up. The crossover.
Nothing but net.
And they now go up by 6. They're getting set to inbound the ball. Number 32 inbounds the ball. Launches one from beyond the arc. Pulled in by number 15. The visitors with a lot of momentum. Dishes on top of the key. Withers puts it up. Knocks it down from 20 feet away. They just keep rolling. 16 unanswered. The Catamounts call timeout. They're losing by 8. 1:59 left in the game. Number 14 hands it off. Takes the shot. Buried from beyond the arc by number 33. He's got 13. 1:48 left in the game. Hammond lets it go. All net. He's 7-for-10 for the game. The Catamounts will take a timeout. They're down by 7. 1:37 left in the game. Has it. Top of the key. The triple was off the mark by number 32. Number 4 brings it up court. Another assist would give him 20 for the game. Number 4 dumps it to the paint. That last 11-footer made by Brooks.
The D has no answer for this. They just can't be stopped.
The steal by the away team. From deep. Perfect shot by Hammond. They take a 12-point lead. Number 14 inbounds the ball. Number 10 to end the run. Brooks grabs the rock. The visitors look like they have this one wrapped up. Number 15. That last shot netted for 3.
Great job to hang on to the lead. They're doing it all out there.
Bounces it inside. Number 32, right in the bottom of the bucket.
A dynamite bounce pass. The D never saw it coming.
Saw it going, though, right into the net. Number 32 gets it. Baseline. Shoots it. Nailed from three-point range by number 10.
Well, that guy will kill you out there behind the arc. If he can't get a hand in his face, who knows how many trays he'll knock down.
That's the game. The away team knocks off the Catamounts 96-86.